Hello everybody and welcome to another Makina Editorial. Ang pag-usapan po natin ngayon ay yung nangyari recently doon sa Boss Ironman Endurance Challenge 2023. And I'm not just talking about them actually, I'm addressing all endurance challenges out there. Alam nyo, dito sa industriya natin, in our motorcycle community, we cannot stop talking about safety riding. We cannot stop pushing responsible riding. Huwag na tayo paligoy-ligoy pa. Delikado talaga ang pagbumotor. You're talking about two wheels and you were exposed. Imagine a collision between a car and a motorcycle. Obviously, bihado yung motorcycle rider. Delikado talaga yan. We have to keep on pushing for safety riding. We have to keep on pushing for responsible riding. The biggest motorcycle events in the Midwest happens June every year. Yung burlesque is, it's the art of the tease. Bale, striptease siya. And yung getup nila, mga pinup girls nung 50s and 40s. Of course, back in the day, this was looked down upon, but through the years, naging art na siya, the art of the tease, di ba? Burlesque. And in the Philippines, we also have that, pole dancing. Back in the day, this was looked at as something cheap and crass, but nowadays, it's a form of exercise, it's an art form as well, it's a dance. So what's my point? Anong connection nito sa Boss Ironman and endurance challenges? Hindi po lahat ng sumasali dyan or nanonood dyan ay lumalabas ay nagiging rapist, right? May mga nanonood dyan or nagpa-participate dyan na hindi naman manyakis off stage, right? All I'm saying is, rapists are rapists, kamote is kamote. The Boss Ironman Challenge 2023, we had over 1,800 participants over there. Bakit ang dami naman doon nakarating doon sa endpoint, safe and sound, right? The ratio between the accidents and those who finished it safely, is there's a huge gap there. Am I defending the organizers? Am I defending endurance challenges on public roads? No, I'm not defending them. I am defending the right of a rider to do this safely and within the boundaries of the law. You might think, I've heard this also, Zach, alam mo, Zach, pag wala ng endurance challenges, di wala ng aksidente, wala ng mamamatay taon-taon. Alam nyo, kung wala ang mga endurance challenges na yan, ganun din. Riders are still gonna go out there on their own. They're still gonna do this. Ibabrag nila sa social media, nagawa ko po ito, naka Philippine loop ako in X amount of days. Nagawa ko yung Luzon Loop or 1,200 kilometers, gantong number of hours lang. There's always gonna be that person who's gonna do that. Accidents happen every day, you know? In fact, meron may chance ang mga organizers ng mga endurance races na ito to actually even push for safety riding. And I'll get to that in a bit kasi you might be thinking, paano naging safety yan, di ba? I'll get to that in a bit. The other day, I was thinking about the point of all of this. Ano nga ba yung point na gagawin natin to? Magpapagod ako 1,200 kilometers in X amount of hours gagawin ko. Ano bang naitutulong ito sa lipunan? I mean, why am I doing this? And then I also thought, teka, yung mga marathon runners, those people who run from Manila to Baguio and wherever, I mean, ano rin yung point? Why are marathon runners doing that too? I mean, what's the point, right? Anong naitutulong yan sa lipunan? I have one word that can explain all of that, and that is sports. Human beings have this urge to break barriers. Human beings have this urge to be competitive. Meron tayong urge to become better versions of ourselves. Kung ano yung na-achieve ko kahapon, gusto ko ma-beat yan today. It's just the way it is, right? Ganyan tayo. However, it has to be done in a safe environment, and it has to be done in a lawful way, na walang nasasaktan, na mga inosente dapat hindi nadadamay. So here comes now these challenges, diba? If the person is doing it within the boundaries of the law, then you cannot stop that person, diba? Isa mga naririnig ko is, ito mga challenges na to, yan nga yung parang nagbubuyo pa ng recklessness on the road. It's parang encouraging daw the riders na to be reckless. The rules of Boss Ironman and the other organizers then, they keep on saying this is not a race. Ito ay endurance, meaning if can you ride this distance at a certain amount of time and within the boundaries of the law. Yan lang naman yung sinasabi nila parate. So what happened in Ironman? I was only able to see two videos. Yung isa, yung van, bigla na lang nag-U-turn. Nawala sa lugar, hindi tumitingin, bigla na lang nag-U-turn. So yung oncoming motorcycle riders, bigla sumalpok sila, 'di ba? So sino may kasalanan doon? Again, wag natin isipin na may event. This could have happened on a Monday at 8 a.m. regular day. Bigla na lang may mag-U-turn. Anong kinalaman ng event doon? Yung non-participant na yung nag-U-turn ng walang saysay eh. Is it the challenger's fault? Yung isa naman, puting kotse, bigla siyang pumunta sa lane ng kabila, oncoming traffic, at sinalubong na yung participant. So anong kinalaman din ng event na naman doon? Do you see any semblance of recklessness coming from those motorcycle riders? They were in their lane. Sinalubong sila ng kotse. Let the number speak for itself sa akin lang. There's a huge amount that are able to do this safely. And then there is the few. Some of them are kamote, and some of them are accidents because of other kamotes on the roads that are even non-participants. You're talking about, yun nga, like the videos that we saw. Kamote yun on four wheels. Yun ang nangyari dyan. It's sad that, you know, accidents happen. But if we're going to say na iban na natin yan lahat, alam nyo, kung gusto ninyo talagang 100% wala na aksidente sa ating bansa, ang solusyon dyan, wag na tayong lahat magmotorsiklo, wag na tayong lahat magkotse, magbisikleta na lang tayo lahat. At the very worst case scenario, pag may road rage dyan, magsusuntukan na lang sila dyan o magbabatuhan ng bisikleta. Pero wala nang mamatitinding crashes, diba? Kung yan yung gagawin nating logic. But let's be realistic. Of course, di naman pwede mangyari yun, diba? That's never gonna happen. So what can we do? We push for safety riding and responsible riding. That's it. Ayoko naman ng ngaw-ngaw lang ng ngaw-ngaw dito. And I have some suggestions for the organizers that maybe they can consider. Yung mga ibang mga bikes natin dyan, sobrang high-tech, pwede na niya i-record yung ride history mo. So, it can tell you how fast you were going at a certain time and place. Right? So, yan yung key. Alam natin kung saan ka nag-overspeeding o lumalabag sa batas, alam natin yung lugar, at alam natin kung kailan. Kung yung bike mo walang ganyan, you can still have your ride history using these GPS apps, right? So, why am I suggesting this? Meron kasing cooperation ng local government yung ating mga endurance challenges na ito. Kasi nagagawa nila eh. I mean, it had to get some approval from government. In fact, nung opening ng Boss Ironman Challenge, meron tayong mga speeches from politicians. So we can see that they are endorsing it. Ano yung silbi ng ride history na ito? Ang maganda kasi dito, after matapos yung karera, yung ride history ng rider, kailangan isubmit niyan sa police. Titignan ngayon yan ng law enforcement. Biglang, meron na silang when, meron na silang where, and meron na sila kung ano yung violation. Overspeeding, saan, dito sa lugar na to, at may oras. Therefore, kaya na nila tikitan yon. Ang problema kasi, hindi ka pwede lang basta-basta magtitiket na, oy, overspeeding ka, sasabihin ni rider, saan, kailan. Hindi, dumating ka dito na mabilis eh. Hindi, kailangan mo ikasi ilagay yun eh. Diba? I mean, it's part of the process of writing a ticket out. So, with that ride history, biglang pwede ka rin masuspende ng lisensya. Pag nakita nila doon, diba, nag-go 180 ka for 5 minutes straight, talagang banat ka na talagang ganan, reckless na talaga. It can also show them how fast you were going in the corners. They can already, I mean, there's a point system here that we can formulate kung reckless na yung rider, hindi. Makikita mo naman eh. 120 in a corner. Is that safe in public roads? Diba? So, I think that is a great deterrent. Ito na yung sinasabi kong paano natin maitutulak, magagamit pa yung mga endurance challenges na ito to promote safety. Diba? Biglang, imagine that challenge. I mean, just open your mind. Challenge ko to ah. Kailangan hindi lumabas yung inner kamote ko. Kailangan magawa ko to. Which is yun naman talaga yung point in a safe manner, diba? That's a great challenge. And then you're already espousing and proving, oh, ito, kami mga motorcycle riders, nagawa namin to safely. Diba? Nagawa namin to without breaking the law. Napakaganda ng imahe natin bigla pag ganyan yung tirada natin. It's a tall order and I hope the organizers can consider it. And yung mga rider, imagine that. Mapapaisip pa ngayon, ang totoong purpose ito is an endurance race. Hindi ko kailangan magpakawalwal at hindi ko kailangan magpakakamote. Kasi titigdan ng pulis yung aking ride history. Right? So, those are my two cents dito sa whole endurance challenge na to. I think this can be used to still promote safety riding. Condolences sa mga namatayan sa nangyari. And to those who are suffering right now because of injuries, I hope you all get well soon. And yun, I think what's done is done. We can only improve. Ika nga, I hope we can move forward together and make this thing even safer and better even for everybody. If you have any suggestions as well on how to improve on this, you can put it in the comments below. This is Zach for another Makanay Editorial. Ciao.